The protagonist we are going to disassemble today is a portable necklace fan and see how it works. Let's take a look at its packaging box first. The texture of this box is very good. From the picture of the box, it comes in white as well as green and pink. There are also product parameters and some certification marks on the box. We see a pink dot on the top. This is a color sticker, indicating that the fan inside is pink. Well, open it, let's see what's inside. There is a USB charging cable. It is a Type-C interface, and it needs to be connected to a 5V1A plug. And there is a lanyard. Let's take it apart and see the length of this lanyard. This lanyard can be adjusted in length. Okay, let's take a look at the appearance of this small fan, its front and back. Its material is ABS/electronic components plastic material. The surface is smooth and textured. Press the switch key, the fan starts to work. Press it again to turn on the second speed. We can listen to the sound of the fan when it is working. This is the digital display of the fan. It can display the gears of the wind speed. There are three gears in total. The battery level can also be displayed. Let's try its wind power now. Take a tissue. The tissue is easily blown away. And then we try the box. The box is shaking. The fan can blow the box down on the table. If the fan runs out of power, we charge it through the USB charging cable. After inserting the USB cable, the display will show the power. When it is fully charged, we can continue to use it wirelessly. These small round holes on the back are its air inlets, and there is a desktop bracket in the middle. When working in front of the computer, we can stand up the fan and face the air outlet to ourselves, and it is a desktop fan. Well, let's turn it off first, then we'll look at its internal structure. We have to tear off the sticker and see two screws. These two screws are fixing the bracket. We'll turn the screws out and remove the bracket. After removing another screw, but it seems that we still can't separate the shell after the screw is removed. It should be fixed by glue inside. We use auxiliary tools. It seems that it still doesn't work. We start from the middle and pry open the cover. Yes, we can see a fan. Turn on the switch. This is the working state. We pry it open from below, and the cover of the air outlet falls out. Now we can see the internal structure of the fan. This is the battery. The battery capacity is 2000 milliamp hours, and there is a motherboard. We remove it. This fan can also be disassembled. Let's disassemble it to see what's under the fan. Below is the motor of the fan, which is used to turn the fan after power is turned on. After my efforts, I found that this motor cannot be disassembled. This is its battery with battery parameters on it. This is the interface of the battery. I just accidentally pulled it out. I'm going to put the cable back in now. Okay, this place is the interface for connecting the fan. This is the LED display. This is the main control chip. This chip has written a program so it can control the gear position of the fan and the screen of the display screen. Its working principle is that it is powered by a battery, and the chip on the motherboard drives the rotation of the fan to work. Well, this is the internal structure of the mini fan.